Thank you, Chris. Let's talk about these rock falls, okay? Because they've happened at least three times, and it's a dangerous thing, right? Now, we're not sure what caused the recent rock falls on Oahu. One likely culprit is the rain that we had at the end of January into the beginning of February. We had rain quite a bit, which may have loosened the soil around the rocks, causing them to eventually fall. But whatever the reason, a lot of people are wondering how they can keep this from happening to them. Joining us this morning is Steve Martel. He's a professor emeritus, Department of Earth Sciences, University of Hawaii at Manoa. Good morning, Steve. Mahalo for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
So we appreciate it. So first of all, I want to say that we are not going to go into the causes of the three incidents that we've had over the few weeks. Neither of us have been there or checked it out or investigated it. But we can talk a little bit about how they happen. But first of all, Steve, what is the difference between a rock slide and a rock fall?
Okay. In a rock slide, the rocks slide, just like the name says, and they stay in contact with the ground. And most rock slides tend to travel relatively slowly and usually tens of miles an hour or less. There are some gigantic submarine rock slides that have occurred all around the Hawaiian Islands, but the rock slides and the slopes above sea level tend to be pretty rare in Hawaii. And I'm distinguishing here between rock slides and landslides. Landslides involve a mixture of soil and weathered rock. And in some areas of Oahu, there are problems with landslides. Rock falls, on the other hand, involves rocks falling off steep slopes or cliffs and then tumbling and bouncing down the slopes below the cliffs. And rocks from rock falls can reach speeds of 100 miles an hour or more. And they can bounce a few hundred yards past the bases of the cliffs that they fall from. Also, yeah. Even a rock about a yard on a side, such as the ones that you showed on the highway a minute ago, they can weigh several tons, and that's about as much as a big rig cab. So when you're thinking about the size and weight of these, you can think about a big rig cab going down a highway, and that's how fast and how heavy they are. Yeah, and these falling rocks can knock down mature trees very easily. So the rock falls are dangerous.
Yeah, not to mention hitting houses. So, I mean, it's difficult to discern how these recent rock falls, and the ones we've seen have been rock falls, but it's hard to discern how they happen, especially given that the three separate areas on Oahu. I mean, the rain probably had something to do with it. But generally speaking, Steve, what else can cause this to happen?
Well, weathering over thousands and thousands of years is one big contributor. Another thing that can happen is when the roots from plants, like trees, they'll drive down to the cracks in rocks and they'll help wedge the cracks open, and those cracks can then grow and cause the rocks to come off. I heard you mention a little earlier that the wind blowing on the trees can make trees wiggle around, and those the stresses from the wiggling trees can be transmitted through the roots to rocks, and that can cause them to come down as well.
Okay, so outside of people living near hills or the mountains, what can people do to determine how much risk their house might be or they might be? I mean, is there a way to determine if rocks near their houses are unstable?
If they're below cliffs, that can be a general problem, but they can also contact professionals at some of the local geotechnical firms on Oahu, and the city and county has some material available there. A search online can also reveal some other material that can help be used to gauge the element of risk at a particular household.
Yeah, well, you know, I don't want people that don't know anything about this going up the mountains to see if the rocks are unstable. But okay, one last question, Steve. What can you do to protect your house? I mean, are there fencing or walls or anything like that?
Yes, there are engineered fencing, engineered walls, and in some cases, wire mesh can be draped over slopes. You can see examples of that at Hawaii Kai and out near Makapu'u.
Steve, thank you very much for joining us from Oregon. And we really appreciate this at this time because people are worried about it. They want to know what they can do. So we appreciate your advice.